Good morning, students. Welcome to KTK Higher Secondary School. Due to COVID-19 situation, we are unable to conduct regular classes. Therefore, we have started online classes. Now we will start with Maths. Chapter 1. नंबर 16. स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर ऑलरेडी फेमिलियर विद डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ नंबर. वन बाय वन वी विल रिवाइज ऑल नंबर्स एंड देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. फर्स्ट इज नेचुरल नंबर. The symbol which is used to represent natural number is n. N stands for natural. And now these natural numbers include the numbers starting from 1 up to infinity. First member of this series is 1 and last member is infinity. Now next set of numbers is whole numbers. The symbol which is used to represent whole number is W. W stands for whole. Whole number includes natural number as well as 0. So first member of this series is 1 and then natural number. Last member of this series is infinity. Now next set is integers. Symbol which is used to represent integer is Z. Now this set includes natural number is arity inverse as well as 0. There now Z stands from Zerin. That means Zerin means to count. So now this numbers include negative numbers minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. First member is also infinity, last member is also infinity. Now next number is rational number. The symbol which is used to represent rational number is Q. The word rational, it is derived from ratio. R stands for ratio and the symbol Q is derived from quotient. Now, the rational numbers are the numbers which can be represented in the form P by Q, where P as well as Q both are integers. Next condition which is necessary that a given number is rational number is Q not equal to 0. What will happen if Q is 0? In that case, if Q is equal to 0, in that case P upon Q, that is P upon 0, which is not defined. Therefore, the condition here written is Q not equal to 0. Now we will find out equivalent rational number. Now example is minus 25. Can it be a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. Why? Because we can express it in the form minus 25 upon 1, where p is equal to minus 25, q is equal to 1. Both P and Q both are integer and therefore and as well as Q is not equal to 0. Now equivalent rational numbers. Is also you know, suppose we take the example of half. Then this can be converted into equivalent rational number by multiplying by 2 by 2, that is, it is 2 by 4. If you multiply it by 3 by 3, then it is converted into 3 by 6. Similarly, we can convert it into 4 by 8, etc. So, such numbers are known as equivalent rational numbers. If you want to represent equivalent rational numbers on number line, we will represent it on the same point on the number line. So this is 0, 1, 2, minus 1 and minus 2. So all these points, 2 by 4, 3 by 6, 4 by 8, then the radix form is half. So we will represent it here. So this is half. All these equivalent rational numbers are represented on the number line in this way. Now we will discuss about the questions from the textbook. First is E0 a rational number? First question. E0 a rational number? Can you guess whether 0 is a rational number or not? Yes, 0 is a rational number. Why? Because we can represent it in the form 0 by 1, where P is equal to 0, Q is equal to 1, as well as Q not equal to 0. This is the first example. Now next method is to find out the rational number between given two numbers. How to find out rational numbers between given two numbers? So, given, let the given two numbers are 2 and 3. We want to find out any 3 rational numbers between 2 and 3. So first, to find out the average of that, if let R be 2 and T be 3. So first rational number between them is R plus T upon 2. That is 2 by 3 upon 2. Now if you want to find out next rational number, then add the number to first one, that is 2 plus 5 by 2. Again find out its average, 2 to the 4, 4 plus 5 upon 2, it is 9 by 4. Now next rational number is add this 5 by 2 to 3, take its average, 5 plus 6, that is 11 by 4. This is the first method. If you want to find out the rational number by another method, next method is if you want to find out 3 rational numbers. Then 3 plus 1 is 4. Multiply and divide both numbers by 4 by 4. That is 2 into 4 upon 4, 3 into 4 upon 4. It is 8 by 4 and 12 by 4. Now write down the rational numbers in between them. It is 9 by 4, 10 by 4 and 11 by 4. So this method is easy as compared to this previous method. Now we will discuss the sum from exercise 1.1. Question number 2. Find six rational numbers between 3 and 4. Now we will follow this method too. If you want to find out six rational number, that is 6 plus 1 is 7. Therefore, multiply 3 as well as 4 by 7 by 7, which is 21 by 7, and this one is 28 by 7. Now, write it. These are the six rational numbers between those two primal numbers, which are 3 and 4. Now we'll discuss with question 3. Find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Okay. Now dear students, we have solved the sums of exercise 1.1, question number 2. Now tomorrow we will start with question number 3 of exercise 1.1. Okay. Till then, revise all questions which we have done today.